My name is Søren Sveistrup. I'm the creator and writer of The Killing. Well, the idea comes from me wanting to explore what really happens in with just one murder. What is the consequences of just one murder? Usually we just in other shows, we just wrap it up and it's easily forgotten. The killer is caught and we all move on to another show. And in this show, the original show, I wanted to explore what happens when something that terrible happens to a family. What happens in society when certain people get to be suspects. It's about one domino piece falling and then taking all the other domino pieces with it. It has different focus points, really. It has three, of course. There's a strong family story. I wanted to explore, could a very strong and loving family survive a tragedy like this? And then it has a political aspect. I wanted to see if a certain politician could survive as an idealist, even though he was a suspect in a murder case, and could he gain power by his idealism, or was he going to be corrupted? And then, of course, there's a story of Sara Lund, as the heroine of the story. I wanted to see if she would be able to solve the case, or would she rather pursue her own happiness? I mean, would she rather be selfish and egoistic, or would she sacrifice herself for a greater purpose? I have a fascination of the politician's world. I have a fascination of the police world, and of course of the relatives too. So I just tried to merge everything to one big melting pot. There were a lot of course, I wanted to do, I was thinking about doing something that was typical for a modern way of life, but also that had some kind of myth behind it. A lot of, it had a sense of Greek tragedy, maybe, a destiny drama. It should be a destiny drama. People that had absolutely nothing in common suddenly had something in common because of one murder. Everybody was tangled up in this big enigma, and nobody could be able to breathe in this claustrophobic world before the murder was solved. The Killing is much a story about we try to choose our lives, but we are destined, maybe in some respect, for something different. I mean, life is what happens to you while you're busy making other plans, as John Lennon said, and that's pretty much also the premises, one of the premises for The Killing, because all the characters, they want to, of course, to do something else than be occupied with this killing. Nobody wanted the killing, but suddenly they were wrapped inside this enigma, and they are all forced to try to move on and try to solve it. So, do I believe in destiny? That's a tough one. I guess I do. Yes, I guess I do. I'm not necessarily saying that the audience have to watch The Killing and reflect upon it as a Greek tragedy, but it has just these layers. You can just watch it as a crime story, and maybe you will also see that it has other references also to the Old Testament and stuff like that, but it's not necessary. You don't have to be brainy or anything to watch it. It's a story written with a heart. I mean, the real focus is, of course, on the on all the sadness and the sorrow that this horrible incident brings with it. Well, the character is very much also a product of the actress Sophie Grubbel. Thinking, because she has a great deal of importance and impact when it came to creating this character, you know, as a writer, I of course try to do something different. I know the cliches of this genre, and of course I know the main characters. They are usually created in a way that's you know, what there's a recipe to it, and we wanted to do something different. You're trying to do something different, something new. Every time you try to write a line, you try to do something different and new. So Sara Lund was, of course, also a product of thinking new, trying to have a heroine not being that feminine, not walking in high heels, not being friendly, not being, you know, she's basically an alien. For me, she's an alien. We took her from outer space and replaced her in Copenhagen at a certain time, a certain place, and then that's it. I mean, and she was meant to be like that. She shouldn't be too obvious to read. So she was even an enigma to me. I don't know everything there is to know about Sara Lund, and I don't want to know, because then she loses. Then I lose my fascination of her. I don't know who believes in a character that both can be very talkative about her private life while she's solving a big difficult murder case. I mean, it can't be done. So it was more obvious that we had to have a character that was not talkative and being like an alien, and then just having everything around her being absorbed by this crime. But she's, of course, Sophie Grobbelt is a fantastic actress, and I owe a lot to her for the killing, yes. Apart from Sophie Grobbelt, I would say, well, there were so many great actors in the killing. There's a lot of great things to be said about them, and there were great writers. I had two co-writers to work with me, and the directors were fantastic too. And then sometimes when you do something, you don't even know if it's going to turn out good or bad, but if everybody tries to play the same tune, if you imagine some kind of orchestra, then everybody is conducted to be trying to play the same tune. That was a feeling I had when we did magical stuff, and that's exactly the moment you're thinking, wow, maybe we're doing something great, but it doesn't necessarily mean it's a success for the audience, but it means that when you are working as a crew, it means everything, because you can feel the magic. So but then the audience loved it, and that has been great. I love the original version, and I would love the North American people to watch the original. Yes, there was really no job. I was asked in collaboration with Danish Broadcasting Corporation if we wanted to sell the remake rights, and we discussed that back and forth, and we decided yes. And then, because I was absorbed with work for The Killing 2 and 3, I couldn't be closely related to the American project, so it was never an issue. So it was like a baby I said goodbye to, and a new baby was raised in the US.
Are you happy with that new baby?
I must be very honest to say I had never seen the American version. I've only seen the first two episodes, because I worked on the side while they were shooting and programming. So if it became too confusing for me to relate to that show, because I had already done that, so I preferred not to watch it. I will watch it some other day, but I can't really be the judge of that, no. It was a big influence. I was a big fan of Twin Peaks back then, and you know, Twin Peaks for me is a comedy. It sounds strange, but it's a comedy because it's so grotesque, and we used to we laugh at these characters, you know. And I loved it at the time. But when I was going to write this, I knew I didn't want to do a comedy. I wanted to do something that especially took in all the feelings for the family, the relatives to the dead girl. So it was something entirely different, but of course there's a lot of hellos, you could say, greetings to Twin Peaks. For example, in the first episode of Twin Peaks, you find the girl in the first scenes. In our show, you find the girl in the last scenes. So we did reverse, but there's a greeting. So I will never compare myself to Twin Peaks, because I think Twin Peaks in many ways is a masterpiece. But you know, I'm happy that there's some people asking me about it, because it's then it gives me the chance to be to pay my debts to David Lynch. Yeah. It's difficult to say, because it's not something new. It's not something that just happened overnight. It's really, in Denmark, there's been a lot of people before me working very hard every day, trying to do good television shows. So why is it happening now? I don't know. Everything has to do with timing. And I think that Stieg Larsson did a fantastic job for the Nordic noir genre. And I don't feel that, maybe we opened some doors, of course, television-wise, but Stieg Larsson did the whole thing, I think, and we owe him a lot too. And then you could say that in general, I think in the Nordic countries we have the tradition for telling stories, strong stories with a social criticism. And right now, that kind of storytelling is modern, is cool in Europe, and it feels good. But actually, it's not something new. Yes, it's reversed. I don't think it has been done before, actually. No, it was an honor to experience that. I haven't been involved in the project deeply, but My point is that if somebody feels that this story is so universal that it can be told on other platforms, I think they should. I don't know. You have to ask me a few years from now. Right now, I'm trying to work on new projects. We'll see what they'll turn out to be. Hopefully, this was a great journey for me. Hopefully, there'll be a new journey on something, yes, entirely new.
Something of HBO, something related?
No, I don't think it'll be HBO, but let's see what it will be. We never know.